Hello everyone, this is Jason from Primetime Aquatics, and in this video we're going to be doing part two of our fish room tour. By the way, if you missed part one, I'm going to put that in the description below. We're going to be looking at the 40 gallon tanks behind us, as well as the low boy and a couple tanks underneath that, 9 tanks in total. If you're looking for more information on the fish featured in this video, check out the description as well. We'll have a lot more information. Hope you enjoy the video. Thanks for watching. So this is part two of the fish room tour. Super excited to bring it to you. We're gonna be seeing lots of cool fish, shell dwellers, different types of plecos, different types of cichlids. There's gonna be a lot going on, some fish from Lake Malawi, Lake Tanganyika. What we're looking at here is our 50 gallon low boy. This is our Neolamprologus multifasciatus tank, otherwise known as the multi. Probably one of the, if not the most popular shell dweller on the face of the earth. This is a Lake Tanganyikan fish. The Lake Tanganyikan fish like hard water. They like a high pH, and that is something we definitely provide for them because that's our natural water parameters. 50 gallon low boy is an interesting tank because it's 4 feet long, 2 feet wide, and only 10 inches tall. We started this tank with about maybe a half a dozen or so multis a few years ago, and we have produced hundreds if not thousands of these in this tank. It's really awesome to look at. There's always a lot of action. These fish are very, very social. You can see them constantly communicating with one another. They don't prey on their fry, which is awesome. If there's one regret I have about this tank, it's using pool filter sand in this tank. This is a sand that really kind of mats down, and when the detritus builds up, it becomes very difficult to clean. It's a lighter sand. Not all pool filter sand is this way, but this in particular is a little rough. But I love this tank. We've got some hornwort float, and it gives the fish some cover, gives them some confidence. One Finnick Stingray light and a couple of sponge filters are what's kind of powering this. We see we do have a heater here. For some of my Lake Tanganyikans, I like to have a heater as a backup just in case something ever happens to the room itself. Right below this tank, we've got this 20 high. This is a Neolamprologus caudopunctatus tank. Technically, these aren't really shell dwellers, although you see some shells in there because after the parents have their fry, sometimes they like the fry light to go in those shells. We started with 5 of them. We had 2 pairs and then an extra female, and they have produced a lot of offspring over a relatively short period of time. They haven't been eating their fry. This sand I like a lot more. This is the Carib Sea sand, which is really easy to work with. We have a Finnick Stingray light on this as well. Just that one sponge filter. That's the only thing filtering this tank with all these fish. We never had an issue with any kind of water parameter things going on. It's not the best looking tank in the world because the purpose of this tank is to breed these fish, and that's what's happening here. So we don't have a lot of aquascaping because when we need to pull fish out, whether that's fish for the club or bringing them to local swaps and auctions, we want to make sure that we can get to the fish relatively easily. So that's why we set it up this way. We don't sell fish online, but we do sell locally, which is pretty fun. One thing to keep in mind, we have a species profile on these, on the multis that you just saw. In fact, we have a species profile on most of the fish that we're going to see in this part of the fish room tour. If you want more information, just check out the description. We've got a bunch of links in there for species profiles that you might find helpful. So this is a great fish. Obviously the blue eyes really pop. These are the red fin caudopunctatus, so that's why that dorsal fin is a little bit more red than what you might see in other places. Sometimes that fin will be a little bit more yellow, but these have been a great fish. I think we're actually going to set up a second tank for them just to give them some more space. Put one pair in one of the tanks, keep the pair in here, and then maybe split the fry. The only thing I want to show you here is we've got these lizard tail plecos, L10As, right next to the caudopuncts. It's a really cool fish. I think this tank is underutilized, so we're going to be using it for something else in the not too distant future, but really cool, awesome fish. This is cool. So we just recently did a species profile on the electric blue Acara, and we had them all in this tank. We moved everybody out except for a pair, and that happened. So now we've got fry. We moved all the other ones into a 125. We're gonna keep them in here. I was actually gonna clear this tank out for the caudopuncts, and then they did this. So it's just so awesome watching fish have offspring. If you've never had that experience before, highly recommend. You know, breeding fish can be so exciting. This tank here is probably one of my favorites. This is Cyperchromis leptosoma. We also have a shell dweller in here, Neolamprologus brevis. I love this tank. I love the Cyperchromis. We are often asked what types of tank mates or what types of fish can go with shell dwellers. In a tall enough tank, the Cyperchromis are a great option. They're not very aggressive. You can see here there's quite a few of them in this tank. We've actually got a brevis up there in the upper corner. He's got a swim bladder issue. He's been like that since the beginning. He's an older fish. He's always had that problem, but I don't have the heart to call him or anything like that. So he just kind of hangs out. And normally he's not up there at the top so much, but really awesome fish. Here you can see one of the brevis here. Nice shell dweller. They get really silvery. The Cyperchromis are absolutely fantastic fish. The males that you see are the blue with the yellow tails. And then the females, they are the ones that are silver, but they're a mid-water, upper water fish, kind of an open water spawner. So the shell dwellers can take the bottom of the tank. The Cyperchromis can take the top. This is not the ideal setup to have these two combined. You can see here we've got females. Almost all of our females in this tank are holding. That's why that their lower jaw is so big. But ideally, if you had like a 55 gallon, a 75, a 125, you put your shell dwellers on the bottom, these guys in the open water, and you'd have a really cool setup. What I love so much about the Cyperchromis is you saw the females that had the fry in their mouth, their mouth brooders, and then they'll spit out the fry, but when they do, the fry are actually pretty large. In fact, in our fish room, they are the largest fry that I've seen. They don't usually have a lot. Maybe some in the neighborhood are like 3 to 5. Like that's usually what our females spit out, but you'll see them swimming around and they're pretty, I mean, they're decent size. Even the adults here love live baby brine shrimp. And so in nature, they like to take small particulate matter, small things that are floating around the water, plankton, and eat that. And so when we can put the live baby brine in there, it's just, they love it. The adults love it. You could see the males, some of the males are showing off, which is pretty cool. This is a 40 gallon breeder on that back wall, Pseudotrophia sillosi. This is actually an Mbuna from Lake Malawi. Right now you're looking at 4 males and a female. There is another female down by the sponge filter on the left hand side, but she's got a mouthful of fry. So when that happens, they tend to just kind of go off to the side. We're going to pull her out of that tank pretty soon because she's been holding those fry now for a couple of weeks. And right now is about the time where I like to pull them out, put her in her own tank, let her relax, not have to worry about all the energy, you know, the action and stuff going on up here. And then she can spit the fry out when she's ready. This is a bad ratio we got going here. In fact, I'd probably like to even see it flipped, but it's worked. They've grown up together and you can see the males, they'll chase each other around, but they don't fight. This 40 gallon breeder has got our star sapphires in it. We've got 3 males, 2 females. These fish are gonna be moving to a 75 gallon relatively soon. This is an awesome fish. Right now, they're somewhere, the males are somewhere in the neighborhood of like 6 inches. They're gonna get even bigger. The males have the white spots, that starry night sky, thus the name star sapphires. The females have the vertical stripes that you see. And actually, one of our females in this tank is holding fry. And so we're going to be pulling her out. Not this female, but the other one who's kind of hiding in the back. We're going to pull her out pretty soon and allow her to spit her fry in another tank. But these are fantastic fish. Absolutely love them. They can truly be a centerpiece fish in a peacock tank. This is a fun 40 breeder. I like this one a lot. So what we've got going on here are 2 things. We have our shrimp and pleco combination. I mentioned doing this in the fish room tour part 1, where we had our long fin green dragon plecos mixed with pumpkin shrimp. In this tank, we actually have 10 long fin blue-eyed albino colored plecos, which are really awesome. They're still a little bit on the younger side, so they're not breeding for us yet, but then we've got the blue dream shrimp everywhere. And what's really cool about this tank is we only started with about a half a dozen, maybe 10 blue dream shrimp, and we have hundreds and hundreds in here now. We'll have to go through and maybe call out some of the ones that aren't that nice deeper blue that we really like. But this has been a great tank to watch. Just the community aspects of shrimp, they're just so silly. They're not aggressive at all, so just watching them kind of do their thing, it can actually be pretty relaxing. So this tank here has all the 40 breeders that I've shown you so far, Phoenix Stingray Lights. The substrate in this tank, I believe, is a Carib Sea sand.
and we've got Jungle Val everywhere. And it wasn't necessary, and you can see here this female is holding, so on the bottom side she's buried with eggs, which is pretty cool. But the Jungle Val wasn't necessarily a plan. Here's another female that's got eggs, but it just started to grow out everywhere, and it's providing a lot of surface area for the shrimp to hang out. They've got things to hang on, which is making them feel comfortable, which is pretty awesome. Here's those long fin albinos I was talking about with the blue eyes. These things are super cool. Like I said, we've got 10 of them. I can't wait till they get old enough so we can start breeding them. They're gonna be really super awesome. So it's a really good productive tank for us. Last one I wanna show you, this is the other 40 gallon breeder. More, these are just standard bristlenose plecos. We get some browns, we get some albinos. There's like 70 of them in here. Filtration, yes, we have the sponge filter. And then we also have a Marineland 375 on there. So that was part two. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, share, subscribe, stick around for part three, which is coming up next.